I think Nigerians think there is some magic going on in the CBN, so if Naira is falling, the CBN governor can just open his magic cap and, make some magic and Naira will rise. So they abuse him. They say, oh, this man is so useless. He should get out if he doesn't know what to do there. But, it's not the man's fault that you guys like lavish foreign things. I will explain. Anytime we demand for dollars, it affects the Naira. When there is excessive demand for dollars, the Naira weakens. We demand for dollars for everything. We don't want to buy made in Aba. We want to buy foreign, So we demand for dollars to shop in Dubai, in London, in the UK, and buy designer stuff. Even if we're not buying designer stuff, we just don't want to shop in Nigeria anyways. Maybe if more Nigerians should shop in Aba, if more Nigerians should shop in Onitsha, that's going to improve the value of the Naira. I don't know if you get what I mean. Another thing is we all demand for dollars to travel to, travel to Spain, to France, to go for holidays abroad. Maybe we need to start having our holidays in Nigeria. That way, we demand less dollars. For instance, instead of going to London, you can go to Niger State and look at the Gurara Falls. You can go to Taraba State and look at the Mambila Plateau. It's also beautiful. You can go to Kogi State and look at the confluence town. The confluence town where River Niger and River Benue meet. That's also a beautiful sight, you see. But we don't want anything to do with Nigeria. We demand dollars to travel and to shop, and then we come back and abuse the CBN governor. No, we need to calm down because you know why? We're part of the problem.
Another problem we have is that many companies in Nigeria like to hire white men and pay them in dollars. I mean, we hear about Nigerians doing great things abroad, breaking bounds, in medicine, in engineering, in law. Across many fields of life, Nigerians are winning abroad, But in Nigeria, many companies would rather hire a white man to lead a team or do some specific jobs that Nigerians can do, and they pay them in dollars, which, in effect, is putting strain on the Naira. For instance, you see that our Italian, the very first case of coronavirus in Nigeria, it was a white man hired by Lafarge Cement, That shows you how prevalent it is that many Nigerians hire white people to do what Nigerians can do. I'm not saying that we shouldn't hire experts, but I'm saying there are so many things that Nigerians can do that we don't need to hire foreigners to do it. My take. The rest of the problem is actually on the government. Just imagine Nigeria was not importing fuel. Will you believe Naira would probably be at 20 Naira to $1 or something like that? Because the foreign exchange or the amount of dollars that is required to import fuel, and I'm talking millions and millions of dollars to import fuel that Nigeria uses, for present, and this is one big failure for every present and past administration. How can you be a Nigerian leader and you did not prioritize building refineries? And these refineries, we can actually build them if we manage costs. The cost of governance, the cost of private jets, the cost of living a lavish lifestyle, that can actually build us a refinery. But Nigerian leaders, oh my God. The only thing I can picture is a broom and a dustpan. Sweep them up and put them in the trash because I don't understand why we're importing fuel. And that's one of the biggest challenges of the Naira. Now, we've been talking about non-oil revenue for a very long time. I'll tell you a short story. South Korea built a copper steel plant in less than 1 year. A copper steel plant making copper rods. Ajaokuta Steel Mill has been in progress for the past 40 years. Every government that comes in will campaign with Ajaokuta Steel Mill. They will pretend as if they want to work on it. They will call investors to look at it. They will call the press. They will do photo ops and nothing will happen. That steel plant will remain there uncompleted. For the past 40 years, this is something that South Korea built in 1 year. And right now, South Korea is making over $40 million a year on their steel plant. Meanwhile, Nigeria is putting pressure on the dollars by importing steel for millions of dollars. So tell me, how useless can a government be? And I'm not just talking about present, I'm talking about past. I'm just showing you the hopelessness of the whole situation.
You see, everything Nigeria needs for a strong Naira is abroad. And it's not just the politicians that are responsible for sending them there. Also we the people. The money that could have built refineries are in secret bank accounts. The monies that could have built our steel mill are in secret bank accounts. In fact, the money Atiku has been using to build fancy buildings in Dubai can build refineries in this country. most of us, we support American government, we support the UK, we support Germany, we support many foreign countries by sending our children to school abroad, by shopping abroad, by, you know, of course, many people want a better life. Maybe we feel ours is not good enough. But I think it's also important for us to know that when we're insulting Emeali Fe and calling the CBN governor useless, the problem doesn't just lie with the government. The problem also lies with us. As we pay for school fees in dollars, we shop in dollars, and we holiday in dollars. Thank you for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe to my channel, like and share. I'll see you again next week. I put out new videos every week. Bye.